Tabletop session. So before calling the tabletop master, let me share one story of my friend. I was in first year of my B.Tech, and in the first semester, I got back in my physics paper. This friend of mine, he also got two backlogs. Now what? Yeah. Now what happened? I told my parents that I got a backlog in physics, and I asked him feedback. Did you tell your parents? He told, no, I didn't tell you. Then the next, I know that I told this particular thing to my parents. They are going to ask me in the next semester that I cleared this particular this backlog or not. So that I know that I told it, I have to read and I have to clear it. This friend of mine, he didn't tell, and again in the next semester he got two more backlogs. So this thing happened. By the end of the year, I cleared, by the end of the B.Tech, I cleared all my papers, and this friend of mine having 12 or 13 backlogs in the whole fourth year. Now, I got my certificate, he didn't get it. I faced the truth, I cleared it. He was the person who couldn't able to face the truth, because he was the school topper in 10th and 12th, and this was the situation in the college. Now the same thing happens in the table topic. The topics will be given to you. You come, you deliver your speech, face the truth, and move forward. If you don't face the truth, you will be having backlogs, and you won't be able to become a good speaker. So with this, I would like to call the table topic master. So when I asked him that what made you think this the theme, he told me that he did his he's a doctor actually, and he did his MBBS from Russia. So what it means is, if you are doing MBBS in India, it is called MBBS, and if you are doing MBBS from Russia, it is called MD. Okay, now when he returned to India, in the board he wrote MD Alagappan, Dr. Alagappan. Okay, now I think MCI is there. So what MCI are? MCI, they told him that you cannot write MD because this particular degree is not valid in India. It is valid in India, you can practice. You can practice it. But the thing is, you cannot write it as MD. So what he did, he just put down his board and he started practicing. He started practicing without the board. Now what happened? He faced the truth. The same patients came also. Previously the patients were coming. The same patients also came. So the thing is, you have to face the truth. What the main thing is, it is all your behavior and all your treatment to the patients. This particular thing make you a doctor. So with this, I would like to call Dr. Alagappan.
Because I was practicing with that board, just the joke fell flat actually. So I was practicing with the MD board, and if I take the board and the next day fix it as Alagappan MBBS, and everyone will think till yesterday he was MD and today he got MBBS. So I just thought, okay, this patient, let them forget, okay, after 6 months I will not practice with the board, okay, just I took the board and 6 months I waited, and after that I found that everything was the same. They never care about what is the thing behind my name, just care about the person I am. So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So today, shall we start the TT session? I think everyone knows about the TT session. So everyone is having the caterpillars, right, in the stomach. Sorry, because butterfly story has been told by. So I just thought about that. Okay. Let us a little bit lighten ourselves, so not be feeling very stressed. facing the truth, I just remember one incident. A patient came to my clinic and was sitting, and he asked me, "Sir, nowadays your younger brother, he is not being seen in your clinic. Where he is nowadays? He's not coming." I said, "No, I don't have any younger brothers. Sir, I have two elder brothers only. But and also they don't come to my clinic and all." And he said, "No, sir, he was very similar to you, and he has some sort of little bit hair and and also little smarter." And asked, inquired about more things about him, and then found, and finally understood that he is talking about my father. but I didn't reveal the truth. Okay, then it will be published in only. So I didn't reveal the truth. So sometimes you have to. And I also remember when I understood that my wife delivered the second baby. First baby was a girl child, and we were expecting it should be a boy. And you know, astrologers, everyone told that it should be a boy. And even my wife was lying in one side for 6 months to get a boy. At last, the nurse came and showed, "See your child." My mother was there, and I was there, and this, my mother, "Hey, boy baby, boy baby." "Oh, yes, yes, yes. See properly." And then, "No, nurse, don't mistake. No, it's because of this over interest in boy. Didn't see it properly. It was a girl." And we had two girls. Okay, so I'm having a few set of names, so I'll be calling attendee speakers, and you have to come here and speak for about 2 minutes, right? 1 minute. 1 minute is a qualifying time, and 1.5 minutes we will show yellow card, right? 1.5 minutes. And green will be shown at 1 minute. So minimum time? Red will be at?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay. Thank you. So, shall we call the speakers? First speaker is going to be Toastmaster Ryan. Okay. So, as I am a doctor, I will be having some sort of specialty topics and all. I don't know anything. So, and some philosophy. So, today I am going to tell you about the most dangerous lies, or the lies you tell yourself. The most dangerous lies. Or the lies you tell yourself. Those must be.
Well, good evening, everyone. It's been great. It feels great to come here in this medley again, once again, after so many days. The most dangerous lies are the lies you tell yourself. Indeed, that is true, because let's take an example that there is someone who thinks that they are really great singers. And you can see this example live if you watch this talent shows like Britain's Got Talent or America's Got Talent or even India's Got Talent. Or in those shows you see a poor young little kid coming thinking that he or she is the best singer in the world, can beat any great singers. Go for the audition, is lambasted horribly by the judges, and the poor kid feels humiliated and just simply walks away, thinking, why? Many cases you see the contestant abusing the judges, right? And this is because the person was lying to himself or herself, as well as their parents, their friends, everyone was lying to them. And that is the best example I could give. Over to you, Professor.
So apparently research shows that we Indians, about 90 to 95% of Indians don't do any sort of physical activity. So now, Toastmaster Sundaresan is going to come and deliver a speech or talk on lifestyle modification. Yeah, talk, because these people don't do any sort of activities.
I don't do anything.
And you are a good candidate to tell.
What are you?
Why do you think it is necessary to do a lifestyle changes and to do regular sort of exercises.
One is to keep us healthy. In order to keep us healthy, we have to go work out in the gym or go to jog daily. I try to get up at 4:30 in the morning and go to beach for running, but you know the plan fails horribly. I sleep for like 8 o'clock and I don't get up, and my mom's like, "Yerendira day," and she gets so pissed off, and I mean like going two rooms back and hiding from her scoldings and actually like, I don't know what to say.
I think here I should say the topic and ask who want to speak. Actually, I have one experience, like my friend, because I also don't do any sort of exercise, and he said you get up in the morning, if you want to get up in the morning, do something what you most like in your life, then you will get motivated and get healed in the morning. But then also I got up late, then I understood that I like the most is the sleeping. So next one is, every one of us, we have a purpose of life, right? Everyone will be thinking like, what, why I'm born and what I'm doing, right? So here, going to come Toastmaster Adarsh.
Good evening, a very good evening to all.
Good evening.
My purpose of life, I am 21 right now currently, but apparently I haven't figured out what my purpose of life is. So I'm going to tell you why you should have a purpose of life. Your purpose of life. Your mother, your father, your parent, your family members, everyone will tell you that you should do this, you should do that. Even your neighbors, not even your family members, even your neighbors will come and tell you, you should do engineering, you should do doctor. Even if someone wants to become a singer or a dancer or an athlete, they'll say there is no scope in this. So you become an engineer, your life will be secure, or you go for civil services or whatever it is. So their purpose of life is to see their child prosper in life and to live a happy life. So they think that their purpose of life is your purpose of life, which is not the scenario over here. My purpose of life is how I want to live my life, is how I want to dedicate my life to the society or to myself or to my girlfriend, whatever it is. Yeah, that's all. Thank you.
So next topic, shall I call Toastmaster Priya? The topic is the whole of life, from the moment you born to the moment you die, is a process of learning. The whole of life, from the moment you born to the moment you die, is a process of learning.
Thank you. None is an ocean. Unknown is an ocean. Learning is a never-ending process, right? Yeah, simple. So learning is a never-ending process. That's why today I'm here, to learn something new from the young, energetic Bentley Toastmasters. I feel that whoever you meet in your life, there is one thing which you'll be learning from them. They will surely teach you one thing which you can take forward and to achieve what you want in your life. Recently, one thing which I learned is that I have been invited to be a part of, to become a trainer for surgeon at Arms role for the B and I division. And for that, I went to the trainer event. There I met a person, his name is Deep Saran. He told me, when we were discussing about what exactly I need to train them, regarding to surgeon towns, he only said one thing. Normally people used to think about that particular role as a very, very simple role which doesn't have much importance. But the one thing you have to make sure among the audience is that they should feel that they are the face of the club. They should feel the energy. They should feel the energy to perform in front of the people, because they are the person who comes first to address the audience, right? So the important has to be taught to them. That was the one thing I learned recently, and that is the one thing I implement in my path which I'm moving forward. Whatever I learn, whoever I meet, I try to learn one thing from the person. That will be my core objective of my entire life. Thank you.
So we should be looking with the guest. So any guest? So can you talk about your role model?
I think India is a country which is short of role models. To most of us, our parents are role models. We happen to just blindly follow them, you know, tread the path. Like one of the earlier topics, if your parents wanted to become a doctor, you end up becoming a doctor because your parents didn't. Likewise, you know, if it's an advocate or a chartered accountant or an engineer. So where do we go and look for role models? Is it you go and see the media, like sportsmen, Dhoni your role model, Abdul Kalam your role model? So are we actually, in each of us, are we looking for role models? Or are we just, you know, halfway down the line? You think maybe my life would have been better if there was a role model, and you know, it's now too late for me to go back in time and, you know, do things in a different way. But I think it's important for all of us, wherever we are at our, you know, streams in life, to look for a role model depending on what your aspirations are, and then choose whoever, you know, we know more about, or we can know more about through, let's say, Googling or any kind of research, and then choosing a role model from that point in time, and, you know, will make a difference in life. Thank you.
Again, the next topic is going to be a health topic. So any smokers in the hall? No one is admitting. Okay, right. So any?
He's
admitting. Do you want to talk?
Come.
Please.
Come.
So you're going to counsel these people who are smoking not to smoke. Okay. What are the ill effects and why you ask them to not off?
Yes, ma'am.
So what's your name? Name, excuse me.
Venkatesh. First, I would like to say why that smoke is or was or will be or would be so important in my life, and then I will tell the ill effects. Okay, so I started smoking when I knew nothing about smoke. I have rarely seen a cigarette until my second year, so like, or touched. People used to, you know, smoke, and they used to like give it to me to like, you know, switch it off or like throw it. I just no more. Okay, good. That was me. But one fine day, I had not touched no drugs until then. I was so happy that day. On one rush, that adrenaline push, you know, seeing, I was all happy for another thing. Then I went to the tea shop. Everyone was smoking. I just felt I should get one smoke. I didn't know the name of a cigarette, any name of a cigarette to go and buy it. So the first cigarette I smoked was some cafe cigarette. It was 25 rupees. I didn't know it was a cigarette. It was a Surat tip. I just went and asked, give me the costliest cigarette. Anna, you don't have cost and all the cost of a cigarette. That had a pipe also. So I put it on my mouth. And I just had one drag and I hated it. I hated it. Shit, why did I do that? Why did I do that? But I'm resisting that feeling and just standing over there taking the second and third puff so that I don't get embarrassed among the guys who are standing beside me. You get it? And it started. Cigarette after cigarette, cigarette after cigarette, cigarette after cigarette.
Even if I just get a smell of someone smoking in the corner of the hostel room or toilet or anywhere else, I just want to go pick up a cigarette and smoke. Done. Let's come to the topic. But I tell you, I regret that I built that habit onto mine and I'm struggling to come out of it. In the sense, now too I'll say I'll stop smoking, but I have one cheap puff from my chap. Okay, one cheap. I don't smoke one full cigarette nowadays. But I do smoke, I'll get one puff cheap and smoke. I'm trying to stop that habit. I'll tell you what I will do. It will spoil your entire, you know, this line which intakes the air. See, nose and mouth are together, right? I cough every day. I was coughing every single day in the morning because I don't know the terms, the names, but that will go very bad. It will actually get injured. You can't, every day you wake up, you just have to go to the wash basin and cough. That's very bad. And I'll tell you one thing. You're not just spoiling yourself. You're also spoiling all the friends that there are with you. You're going to give them passive. That's given. You smoke a cigarette before your friend, you're spoiling him. You're going to kill him someday. You understand? You're taking away his life. All these things come to mind. I should not smoke hereafter. But at the end, I'll go buy a cigarette and smoke today. Someday I'll get it lost from my mind. Thanks. Peace. You're so interested, you didn't see the card. You're so interested about telling the cigarette story.
Thanks.
But
you're very motivational. Thank you. Okay, now we are going to the next topic. So, Toastmaster Shruti. So, hope you use WhatsApp, Facebook.